All right, everybody. Today we're going to be talking about call flows in CallRail. Now, call flows are a mechanism and a setting that allows you to handle incoming calls in a really sophisticated way, basically however you want to handle them. So when a call comes in, you typically just think like, oh, the call is going to come in. I'm going to route it to one number. It's going to go to that number, like an office or something, and you're going to be good to go. With call flows, you can do a bunch of stuff. You can route it to multiple people. You can send it to a voicemail. You can just do a ton of stuff. So I'm going to show you what the call flow setup looks like and the different options that are available. So in order to get here, when you're in your interface, go ahead and head over to numbers. And then on the left-hand side here, it says call flows. And then you do create call flow. And you can duplicate an existing one, or you can use one of these fancy templates. So you have greeting to dial to voicemail, where it greets the caller, it then dials someone else, and then it goes to voicemail, or a menu. So I'm gonna do like the greeting menu dial, okay? So configure the call flow. So now you can see, here's how you name the call flow. So they use like this like caret type of approach with greeting menu dial, and then you would hit save when you're done, start the call flow. So then it says, do you want to record the calls? We almost always record calls at Paracore because we're doing lead gen and we want to hear them. So we are almost always recording them. And then it has a greeting. So it says, play message to caller, frequently used to notify about the call recording. So this call will be recorded for quality assurance. Now you can see in the interface that you have like insert step here and you've got this little X. So those different options allow you to edit the call flow. I'll get into that in a second. So if I wanted to delete this step, like I don't want a greeting played, I could hit that. And so I could either delete just this step or delete this step and all the following steps, or never mind, I don't want to delete it. When I scroll down, now it says, now here's an example of the menu option. So prompt the caller to select from a menu of options, read message, press 1 for sales, press 2 for support. And so in all of these, sorry, I didn't mention this earlier, you can have it read by like an automated person where it just transcribes and reads this, or you can record your own voicemail, choose a recording, upload it, and then you it sounds a lot better. So you can really customize it, make it sound however you want, but that's pretty cool because you don't have to then doesn't have to sound like a lame computer recorded message, which a lot of times it does. And so then here, same thing, you can play recording. And then if they press 1, you can forward it to sales. If they press 2, then you could forward to support. And you'll notice that when you click on this, this arrow pops up, comes down, swings over, and then it says here, and it dials this number. Now when I hit this, the caller pressed 2, now I'm seeing a completely different interface, right? So now I get to choose what I want to happen. So with 1, forward to sales, it dials a number that I can enter in. If the destination does not answer within 20 seconds, then what do we want it to do after that? So you have all of these different options around like, you know, if this happens, then that, and it's all just like a bit of a decision tree. So for example, I'm gonna hit this guy here, and you can play a greeting. So this says, we already looked at a greeting, but you can say, you know, thanks for calling, thanks for support, thanks for calling support, we'll be with you in a second. You can dial a number, so this means that some recipient is gonna get the call. You can do a simultaneous call, which means that this dials multiple numbers all at the same time. So if you have like people or multiple customer support people, the simul call will dial all of them simultaneously, and the first person to pick it up will then get the call, which is great. And here you can add numbers, you can change them. And this says prevent voicemails and automated systems from answering the call. So a lot of times, like if a call's coming in, you don't want a voicemail or an automated system to answer it and then like kill the entire call flow. So you can prevent that from happening. And then you can say, route previous callers to the number that answered last time they called. So they could talk to the same person, which is really cool. And then you have this option here that says, if no destination answers within 20 seconds, then go to the next step. So you can keep basically taking people through different steps of this, depending on, you know, if someone answers, if they don't, how many calls it's going out to. So I'm gonna kill this step, I'm gonna delete it. Around robin is different from a simul call, and only from the perspective that it goes through each person individually and rotates between them. So it says allow the call to ring for 20 seconds. So it goes through each one for 20 seconds. So simultaneous call, they all call together. That one, it goes round robin. Or you can do a menu. So this is an example of a menu, which we just went over a second ago. You can establish time of day routing. So basically, if it's during business hours, do this. If it's after hours, do this. If it's a certain day or a certain time, do these different things. So I can say on weekdays between these hours, then do this, right? So, and then I can say on weekends, all day, do this. And this allows you to then create a schedule. So schedule branch if calls received during the following times. And then this is the alternative. And so here's schedule branch A, and I want it to like dial a number. So this can get very, very elaborate and complicated, which is cool, but also can be a little bit overwhelming. And then it goes there with schedule branch A. All right, so I'm gonna add another step here just in the middle. You can geo-route it, so based on the area code. So if the caller's area code matches the following area codes, then route it a certain way. So you can add a location, blah, blah, blah. So here's an area code. So in Phoenix, it's 602, and that's 480, and then it's 623, okay? So that's like the Phoenix location. And then when you click that, you can see this arrow down here goes to do this. And or you can do zip codes. So an alternative is always route to the closest location or route closest location up to 100 miles. So then you have zip code routing, which is really cool. So zip codes are associated with the area codes. So like this is where I grew up as a child, 85022. And you can keep adding different locations. So you can do geo routing based on area code or based on zip code, and then route depending on if they're calling from a certain area code or if they're calling from a certain zip code. And I'm fairly certain that this the area code of the phone has to associate with the zip code. I don't believe that it's like where they're actually geographically located, because they would have no way of knowing that with just a phone call, unless it's coming through some other way, but I don't think so. All right, so that is the geolocation, the geo routing. Responsive routing. So this is route callers based on a custom criteria. And the criteria are first time caller, repeat caller, the source of the caller, the keyword, the active page, landing. So these are all the different campaign variables that you see in the, that comes in with a call. So it's basically saying like, if a call is coming from a certain campaign, which might mean that someone's interested in buying a certain product, then route, so campaign is, you know, AdWords, and then campaign is Facebook, and then you might add a different branch and have them go to different people. Or if it's like a support number, then you might have them go here. Or if it's a department, you might have them go here. So this criteria is pulled in from the number itself. So certain numbers can then go to certain people and so on and so forth. So there are a ton of options with responsive routing. And then finally, the last one is adding a tag. So tagging a call. So if it gets through like a certain decision tree, you can have it tagged a certain way. So it kind of like rolls through here and apply the tags. And then I believe the last step is either hang up or do a voicemail. And so when someone gets to the end of the decision tree, they can either, you can either hang up the call or you can send them into a voicemail where they can leave a voicemail. So again, the call flow is very advanced for CallRail. You can do tons of different things. It's probably way more advanced for most people than you would even need. We use a handful of these features, but we by no means use all of them for Paracore, and then also for a lot of our clients. They just don't need this level. But you can see just the huge variety of options that are available to you through the call flow. So that's all for this video. That's call flows, and thanks for watching. We will see you in the next video. Thanks a lot.